Hello, it is time once again for another first impression vlog. First of all, look at the shirt I got today. When I found it, I knew I had to get it, and I knew I had to wear it for whatever met vlog is. This shirt, looking at to a bunch of shirts I intended for kids. I don't know if you can read what kind, but it's some lame kid joke with Kevin Conspiring in it. I know who shirt came that. It's amazing. I got some you know, shirts that actually ironically good, but and this, I'm not doing for all vlogs. I've gotten it today. I figured, wait for the vlog. Not for any other film. Not like you want it. Anyway, why am I here doing vlog at midnight? Okay, I'm here to talk about DuckTales in 2017. I love talking about the Video Network, so here we go again. Disney decided that not only a very good premiere, a very good premiere of new DuckTales, and it's gonna run for 24 straight hours. Well, that kind of thing would not go well for Cartoon Network, right? I mean, and I thought, okay, they're gonna start, like, 8 a.m.-ish, where, okay, whatever, they've been doing that, as dumb as that is, fine. No, premiering at, well, first I heard midnight, don't turn out at 11, because, you know, the person I was talking to did not believe in Catch-up Time Mastery. but, yeah. So, 11 p.m. when they premiered the pilot. Yeah, the target audience, during stuff. When I was like 12-ish, when it's summer, I do lot there where I feel like it, because summer doesn't really matter, so, okay, fine, but I guess I'm here during the summer, yeah, so, and summer's almost over, well, I know schools tend to, again, they tend to start up during August. I'm not school anymore, so I can't tell you, but looking through the school in my city, at least, I haven't gone to school in the city, because I moved after I, so, you know, but anyway, okay, but, you know, yeah, if they start 8 at 11, 3 hours, I don't know why, you took errors, sporadically errors, again, I don't know why, 11, I guess a little better, because you're likely to have stayed up to that long, we'd already be up a kick, still, dumb, to premiere your brand new show that you're banking a lot on, okay, it's not just the thing they're dropping up, like, you start banking a lot on it. That's why I'm trying for 3 hours, but that's still overkill. The stupidity of network, right? But anyway, we have our latest reboot, and reboot is looking out not too well. Now, I don't hate Power Girl 2015 or Ben 10 2015, but they're not good. They're not good. They just don't. I mean, even on their own, they're just kind of locked up to a cartoon show. You know, you watch an episode, and you're like, I'm going to totally forget that when it's over. Some people think worse things about them, but I think they're kind of sure you go to the episode, you might get some joint, but you're not going to remember them. They don't leave an impact like the original do, or like other shows at the time do, you know, for, you know. You know, and it's a big thing. Reboots, they're playing a good reboot. There's Thundercat, that was good. The Good Friendship Magic, but in some of the iteration of the original Transformer can be good, Drag Free, and I check from Prime, good. I hear check from Animated before, Beast Bill Garber. That's different when you have franchise up going on for God knows how long. So, but it's like, you know. Yeah, that's come about a reboot. Yeah, I've seen some people do it. Some come a good reboot. Marcus Hughes did one, for example. Some good reboots got to go. Other people go. There have been good reboots before, but recently reboot has not been turned out brilliantly. Yeah, Benefit turned out to be. At worst, you get something like Titan Go, which you get, you know, contrast to that one. That's not quite a game leak, because now you're trying to be original, trying to become different, which I give it credit for. But, anyway, go with Disney guy to reboot DuckTales, a lot of people were worried, because, you know, Disney seems like you're copying on the same gun, you know. Now, I should probably talk a bit about the original DuckTales gum. I like it. I haven't seen an awful lot of it. I don't even think I've seen the movie. I've seen parts of it. It's one of those things. You watch part of the video, watch the whole thing, and at some point I'll watch the whole show. But from what I have seen, it's pretty good. Again, I don't think I prefer, like, Darkwing Duck and stuff like that. But I do think it is definitely a high point for Disney Afternoon. It's a very fun adventure show with new characters, especially Scrooge, and, you know. Yeah, who do you get kind of flat, but they're likable. Likably flat, I guess. You know, compared to Quack Pack. You know, so, yeah, definitely a fun show, and I feel like, I thought it had potential, because, you know, it's like, I don't know, that's a little thing I think could But one, unlike Ben 10, Power Girl, they weren't beaten to the ground already. But, you know, Power Girl original hearing already chipped where thin by the time it got to King of Kick. Ben 10, yeesh, they had 2 million off. But DuckTale gets, you know, it gets that kind of bazillion incarnation, whatever. So, the original didn't wear out well too much. It had that spot they were doing at the time. I mean, I think I'm more than 55, I think. But, you know what I mean, had, like, a solid number of episodes for the time. You know, and another reason is they are gambling a really cool, good crew for this. They got, like, one of the writers who was on Wanda Over Yonder, and they got, I think I come over right into them. That Wanda Over Yonder writer, whose name I cannot pronounce, wrote this episode. And they got some, you know, really talented voice actors. And on top of that, the following couple of the crew, you know, on Twitter, and they definitely seemed like they are a big fan of the original, love of comic that DuckTales was based on. The version of the original comic quite a bit. They definitely seem passionate, and they're self-aware about the nature kind of thing, too. So, yeah, I'm thinking of that. I got more hope, and especially for some of the clips, as well as the new version of King Kong, great. I mean, it's not quite the original, but it managed to basically be original, but an updated version, you know. And it's not by my command Disney star. It's someone I didn't even heard of. Felicia Barton, she's probably famous, but it's not. I don't know of her, but that's good. Yeah, they're for trying to run again already, so. Things are looking bright for this show. And, you know, and they have so much faith in it that, yeah, go. You know, and so we have a 40-minute pilot go titled Woohoo, nice. And I'm definitely proud to say that, to quote Drontron, they didn't blow it. They didn't blow it. And this one got to be pretty good. Again, there's room for improvement, but any flaw I have, a problem I have, can be fixed. And I can keep being fixed as time goes on. But in general, this one. Quite a bit of fun, and definitely well done. So, a few things, not a whole awful lot to say, I would, but, everything went on, I think that they didn't play a King Kong until Star Part 2. It clearly have a Part 1, Part 2 divide here, except Star Part 2 when they play a King Kong for me, and, you know, one thing coming out is the animation, which is really good. Again, it's updated, but very much style of a comic. Comic, especially the background being very comic booky, and the actual character comic are definitely well done. Character animation is really good, so it can, you know, it's not like a main family, but definitely pretty good animation, and it definitely, you know, it's not especially colorful. That's the one complaint I've heard, is that it's not the bright colorful show like ever. Because it's trying to be kind of like what comics were. But that's not too big of a deal. You can get used to that. But animation definitely pulled off. They didn't do it. I think their animation, their French was fine. So I'm going to keep playing the vocal recap. Their animation was okay, but it's nothing special. It's very generic, very stale, you know, okay. Of course, I'm not going to get in trouble because of bullshit, nitpicky, small error that happened every show, but. But this show games had a lot of fun to it. Both Disney cartoons do. You know, even some with them aren't good. You know, can have good animation. Even quite back up pretty good animation. And of course, there is the voice acting. The replacement they got, you know, the new guy definitely are. There's so many great people in this. There's Huey, Dewey, and Louie, who are. Okay, let's bring it up. Okay. Huey and Danny Pudi, who named the community guy Ovid. Then we have Ben Schwartz and Dewey, aka Reddy Cunningham. Ian Gocko, that guy in Parks and Rec. John Raffio, the name again. And Bobby Moynihan, aka Panda Free Baron, and Louie. And the Gocko Kate McCucci as Webby. And then some guy in Launchpad, some Perkins and Mickey Beakley. And then the plenty of other people who were very cool. But, yeah, big robot, I'll get that in a minute. When I saw the clip, they were kind of like, A lot of people do kind of that, but where I heard that the people, the vote two guys were voicing Jordan Harold, two obvious adult voicing kid got really jarring to me, especially I heard that even when I saw the trailer. But I saw the movie, it felt, even though it is slightly jarring, but still do a very good job on their own to make up for it. It's kind of like here. Yes, for obvious adults, and admittedly, it's noticeable. And can kind of, if Ben Schwartz, I know, I've heard, I've seen enough of his work and really kind of Parks and Rec to just hear him, but with the other two, it's not quite as obvious when I it did get you looking at their voice enough, and oddly enough, I kept forgetting that that was that kind of, watching We Are Bears with the Bomb this week, except I finished watching, I didn't watch today, yet, but, they do a really good job, I do believe. I know voice more than the other two, so it's gonna be more distracting for me. But they do, again, it's a little bit distracting at first. But they have a nice chemistry of each other. And in terms of the character, as far as can go, they're all portrayed pretty well. Huey, Dewey, and Louie, okay, they're a blank slate, so here they're trying to give them more fun. Again, they're not all fully formed yet, but they're definitely on the way. Dewey is definitely the butt monkey to an extent. And Scrooge is putting him down in that little arc he has, and all characters are portrayed pretty well, and they do things. They do a tiny bit more engaged in terms of the character react because kids do not like movies anymore necessarily anymore. Three, everyone here, so we have to update things a little bit, but they don't do a crap pack thing and make them all just really plain, really annoying stereotypes. Very, I can keep on finding them a little annoying, but they work pretty well. Biggest update that I loved, Webby. They pulled a Lola, where Lucy and Show took Lola from Paint Jam, who's very bland, very bleh, into some with a really fun personality. They do that here. Webby in the original was just kind of annoying carry on. Not actually the word, but that character in terms of that show. The very thing here, where she got actual character. She was like a Coochie, who can everything, by the way. And she curling my Murphy Law. She will get up in Sophia first frequently, and she interests so many things. And true, she apparently almost went up to in the house. And even the movie, she was in that Amazon Netflix movie with Candy Westmore. I was like, what are you doing here for one scene, too? And we also appeared in that movie for one scene, so there you go. Like, appearing together, not the same scene, but yeah, but ugh, that movie. Anyway, and she turned into, she gets you almost kind of a fan girl to type, and she's very excitable, and she's a lot of fun, and, and Donald Duck is also on the show, the guy who voices him, I don't, Tony something, can't pronounce that name, he's doing Donald Duck voice, because now you can tell, but one issue I have that, they do, Donald does have a female voice, but it can be even hard to understand at point, I by default have the captions on when I watch things. I don't need them. It's just something I got used to, like, at an early-ish age, and I just never, I had to control where I'm watching something, so that guy, so I'm going to carry for a DVD, Blu-ray, whatever. So, yeah. But that I can't watch no that stuff, it's just that I got into the habit. So, good thing I had them on, or I probably wouldn't be on the channel sometime. But good, I never had trouble any other iteration of Donald Duck, at least from what I remember. Certainly not the current biggest group they're doing, which I don't know. Why the symbol too, by the way. I guess that's what they did. I guess that's another thing they gave code, because they could do hearing a big short for all really good, watch them for good, then they could pull off a whole hearing. I kind of want them to make a whole hearing out of short. They did a half-hour Christmas special, that was really good, and I hear they want to do more stuff of that nature. So I feel like that's their testing ground for this, because looking in that vein of being really good. But, but Donald got a good subplot where he get a job working for Scrooge's nemesis, the governor, Sasha, whose name I forget. But again, he gets a funny line, especially of him bragging about how much more Scottish he is. I'm wearing a kilt! They got get back to Scottish Disney villain. Sorry, but you're no Duff Killing. Don't leave me on. Like, I give him the bomb for 14 minutes. Anyway, but of course, when it comes to, the other ones are, handled okay too. Watchpad, they can actually, when we're driving here, And he becomes a pilot, and that Blink Lives bad being a pilot, because he's not trained to be one. Okay, cool, I lost pilot. So, being fair, basically, just taking a few minutes at it, but I like her fine. But then we have Scrooge McDuck himself, voiced by David Tennant, and he is perfect. When I heard him, today he was going to be Scrooge McDuck, I went, like, it's a strange way for me, and he is spot on. He done the same, like, you know, and got the original actor down, Young died last year, you know, yeah, I don't know what, I believe the last thing he did at Scrooge was in one of the Wiki shorts. He was excellent. No movie would top him, you know. But Dave Tennant is also excellent. I feel like he can get him, you know. also, Virgo, well, they just threw short the time to this, and well, while time travel, and of course on Twitter, Disney and Twitter, they had to make a dumb joke about it. But hopefully, they have, you know, he took a little short that time to the series. And Scrooge's character is really good here. Here they change it to where he had a well-known thing right from the past, but some people feel like he kind of wants to have lost up and he wants to prove that he's not. And I really like that they kind of add an element here. And of course, very likable. And yes, they do, actually, this might be the thing to feel proper because they had this thing on DuckTales and they had two little shorts that are a video from a couple episodes. And one of them has one of the kids tried to do a thing of, oh no, you can't do that, that's a skill you got a master. If I remember correctly, in a virtual show, there was like a scene where the kid tried to do it and they failed, and they're like, how did you do that? Universal series of self-aware. I've read somewhere they that joke. Again, I've only seen like a few episodes and parts of the movie. Now, I wanted to maybe watch the original, but I'm kind of going with fresh eyes and going compared to what I've seen versus kind of seeing the whole show. But Scrooge is definitely well done. He's probably the best handled character in this, I feel like, along, you know, a little webby, so that can't be possible. And in terms of the writing, the story, they definitely got the adventure element. Part one is more focused on character and introducing a character and having them meet each other. Just standing up a whole time. Kind of like a minor rich element in the scene in the garage, where they have a fun little mini adventure in there. Involving a goat he just kind of has in there. He trapped the goat inside. I'm going to keep it around. But again, make for a fun little scene. And part two, where they go on for adventure to Atlantis. And that can get a lot more rich element. And they go for, go through the Atlantis upside down, so they get a lot of cool set pieces there. And that show will definitely deliver in a good way. So, hopefully, you can keep that up and have a nice little series kind of adventure, but there are a lot of these moments where they're kind of at home and they're, you know, down there forever. And hopefully, they keep that balance. So, we can look at something to feel awkward what they originally were and not. You know, doing something different, fine, but it's like, here, Devin's doing an adventure series, and seeing more of those always a plus to me. You know, and it definitely got that element down, and, you know, and again, it gave him a nice moment. It's never complex, but the character gets some nice moments, and it gets a good element for him. You know, by the end of it, they're, at first, people were like, not so sure about this, you know, arrangement, but they go to you and like him by the end, and, you know, there's some nice believable heart going on here, and there's some fun interactions going on. Yeah. Just, you know, they got that comes up, you know, for character element as well as the metro element. And, you know, again, they got that down. Did the 20 minute thing well? Sure. Could it have been, like, oddly enough, at the end of the part, they could, like, have that be standard episode, and it's freaking a tiny bit going to tag it to one standard episode. Yeah, okay, but I'm not gonna think they'll go on to. Yeah, and, oh, by the way, there are some references to some of the other Disney shows. They reference the hometown from Duke Troop and everything. Something for Death, and I was gonna tweet about that. And apparently, the character looked a lot like Rock Cam from the Goofy movie here. When she appeared, like, that looks like a big, nice sandwich movie, and like, wait, that's big new Rock Cam. I don't know if that puts the actual character or just going to be a lookalike, but the actual show gets ambiguous when I'm seeing it. centered around the same style. Beyond Shadow Paradox is done by, I believe, a creator of that show. He's got no each, just different characters, not game over. Yeah, sure. And who knows what we're gonna, if, who knows if it began Disney Access and acting or anything. Then Paradox was the first attempt to turn it into a show in the movie, but I guess it didn't do that well, so it didn't make Dark. You know, even though a Darkwing Duck movie would have been amazing, and another Goofy movie, which is basically Goofy the Goofy. They're different things, but it's like written kind of the same, and that's not a bad thing. Goofy the Goofy is pretty good. Even like the people, the people, it's fine. You know, no, it's not one of the best. It's good, I think. But anyway, but, you know, but yeah, recognize about Brooklyn Sinclair, and I bet they're probably a lot better than two comics as well. Yeah, and it connects, as far as Reboot goes, it connects blend old and new. They keep a feeling of the original, it feels like it's not going to feel fun, but it's an updated thing, so they make some characters more dynamic than they would be. Webbing's updated, they're going to get a little more personality while still being with filmmakers. They're going to be a part of the show. Which one of these twins, Louie? Yeah, I like that. You know, and it's good. It's like, and again, they do a modern, you know, a lot better than for my Quack Pack, which, again, for that show, I watched one episode for my Disney Cartoon Alley thing, and some parts of that show are actually kind of enjoyable. Literally, for almost, literally, that's one show where we vastly improve the main characters were not in it, which is not a good thing. So we are, everything else got to be okay. But, but this show, everything worked, so the main characters do work. And the hope, and the definition balance between the characters. So, overall, they got it right. They did it. Both games, but if they managed to keep me entertained for 20 minutes, surely they can for a whole series. And they really interested me too already, then hopefully that proved to be a good choice, because the 20-minute pilot was quite enjoyable. Again, I mean, the catcher feed of the visual while adding some new things, but aren't too annoyingly modern. There's a little bit of that with a couple big dialogue, and they have smartphones. But again, they're just there because that's what we use now. The Wii Fit and the Wii Fit, like the phone for the game, something like that. So, yeah, and it's just, it's just fun. It's an adventure series, you know. It's not trying too hard to be modern, like a life is. You know, there will be elements, because not like, again, there are episodes of Kinetic Baron or now, the Valentine's Day episode at the Love Boat. I watched that episode for a Valentine's Day post that didn't happen. And maybe I'll go try that again. DuckTales had a Valentine's Day episode, but no Halloween and Christmas episode. Plenty of horror-themed episodes with here and there, but nothing, and, you know, a few, but nothing exclusively themed around holiday, but Valentine's Day, you gotta have it. No idea why. But, oh well. Maybe something will happen to make up for a Halloween and Christmas episode. So yeah, this thing's definitely a good reboot. Again, the original, I guess, you know, enough of it to really compare. I think about all part of what I've seen. You know, the first one is a classic, so nothing can replace it, generally. But I feel they give a good shot and make something that I think almost as good. I feel like the thing about that original, that it clear that was made in the late 80s and early 90s. Because, yeah, you got that kind of style, I think, over the kind of time. But, like, I mean, that show helped make it. That there are dangerous moments, but that show is the one that truly started it. And, you know, and help. You know, I mean, because it wasn't, you know, based on a toy, it had the original thing, and it managed to stick out on its own. And it had a time, it's timeless because it doesn't pander to the kids of that generation, and managed to stand to the time. You go, the only day element is, the way we write things gonna change over time. The way they write things, certain elements are gonna be a little different. So, but it managed to stand to the time. And this needs to be honored that. There is a little bit of things that are, you know, but nothing explicitly, no, like, hashtag or anything like that. Yeah, that's fun. But again, it's no more dated than the original is. The original, I think, like, yeah, that's definitely 2019 thing. But not, I mean, again, you know what I mean, right? It's not like, you know, so, yeah, this is how you do a reboot. You are the original, but do something different enough, go, you feel like you're not, they change things up a bit enough, go, not watching the same thing play out. It's a different experience because we changed something to make it this thing. Yeah. And again, then maybe they gave a little treatment and that is great. So let's do a DuckTales, sorry, Tailspin reboot where you do Molly better. the Marvel show kind of a carry on kid. That was a trend at the time. Do that. Some of Donald Duck did really well to make the character really likable. So, Tailspin. I'm stumbling over words. I don't know what I'm talking about. But there you go. So, I wonder if they'll open a door for anything else in the future, or we'll do a Darkwing Duck one or something. I would not mind that. You know, in superhero culture, we do need something that's definitely more. Then again, some more jiggers than we have around now. What with your Iron Man and your Thor, whatever. But, yeah. That's my opinion of DuckTales 2017, the first episode. Definitely recommend it. You don't need to see any original. If you see any original, I think that's better. On its own, it's a fun adventure, good Viking character, and good animation, good writing, and all that stuff. So, and as a reboot, it definitely works pretty well. I feel like I do think you'd probably be. I'm in a good position because I'm aware of the original. I've seen a few episodes, but not so much that I can pinpoint to the detail when it got right and wrong. Just to get a general feel of what I've seen. Yeah, and to do something different, so not copy. Yeah. So, this is, I keep good things, and the hearing is called premiering in September, and I can't wait to see what else they have in store. So, three hearings so far, and Tangled I quite like, and this one I like. I like them both more than the original episode they have. It's really fine. I haven't seen the episode beyond what I saw for that. I hear it does get better, but But again, so hopefully I can keep a winning streak of Big Hero 6. Because while both Big and Tango Big Hero coming, they do nothing on their phone, so it's not like they're totally stopping. But that Big Hero keeps turning up more exciting for than the other two because this is a category that I'm actually really good at. Moving go, but anyway, when we get to that show in the fall, probably November, September, way too soon, it is not good by then. So, November, probably. And I don't know when the next first Spider Man will be. I don't know if Nick or Cartoon Network, whether Cartoon Network got anything up a sleeve for the kids, or even it'll film or I'll move to so again for the first at some point. You know, if I hear, the cuffing make a headline, or if I hear of it, so some stuff I probably would have, done had I heard of them, I do wish I would have gotten some of the direct reaction because that pilot was so good and I want to watch more of it, but I'd have the time. But, okay, I think that's enough. So, I shall see you again for good things. So, tomorrow I've had to do it and my little pony and that's for the mess. So, I'll see you tomorrow for the MPVR on whatever the episode is. And we shall see you for that. And I hope you guys check out this pilot if you haven't seen it yet. You have plenty of choices for the next 24 hours. Thank you too, man. Right now, well, I'm a bit of it now. So, there you go. So, hopefully, this is a long, healthy reboot. Especially since the expert title is so impressive. So, see ya. DuckTales, woohoo!